basically the Netherlands is famous for its tulips, which is kind of funny because tulips originated in Turkey. But yeah, that's neither here nor there.
I am the backbone of this channel.
So I said, yeah, you kind of are, along with your cat. Okay. I have opinions. Hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today another Let's Talk Makeup new makeup releases. It is number 71 already. This series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist is down in my description box, as is the community playlist that she was kind enough to create for people such as me to add these types of videos to. The makeup look I filmed, it is done with the Juvia's Place mini palettes. The video is coming. I don't know exactly when. I hope this week. But it could also be next week. It kind of depends on how many looks I still want to cram into that video. At least one, that's the plan. But I'm not sure yet, so there is that. So just, you know, if you're not subscribed already, just click that big red button down below to keep an eye on my channel and you know when I will upload said video. Let's start with an update first from Revolution Skincare. I mentioned these 2 or 3 weeks ago. That they were coming out with kind of a mood range and that I was actually really excited. I'm sorry, I bumped the camera. Let me bump it back. Yes. Depending on what they put in there. Well, it is online. So they have a Thirsty. That's for a dehydrated skin. It's the Thirsty line. Then you have a Stressed Calming line for, basically stressed skin, you know. And blemishes and all that, I believe. Then you have a soothing one, which is called the Angry range. So if your skin is angry, and that is it. I was actually really, really excited about this line. And so when I saw that it was online, I immediately searched the ingredients list. And unfortunately, all the ingredients or all the products in this line have added fragrance or perfume added. So I will not be trying anything. I wish they would stop doing that. You know, the rest of the ingredients all seem very, very nice. But if I have, I don't know, my skin is angry. I'm angry. If my skin is angry, it does not want fragrance. You know? So, I wish that brands would stop doing that. I already have it in my makeup, unfortunately. And yeah, it is the way it is. I also have it in some of my sunscreens because the ones that have fragrance in them work better for my skin than the ones without. So it is kind of pick and choose, you know. But I don't want it in my actual skincare. So I just wish that they would stop doing this. So yeah, rant over. That's my rant. I just wish that they would stop adding also essential oils. I don't need essential oils. Your skin does not like essential oils. Ooh. Anyway, yes, rant over. Let me know if you have tried anything from the line. I do have to say, I advise if you have a very sensitive skin or skin that is easily sensitized or rosacea or whatever, you know, that stuff, stay away from this skincare line, from these skincare lines, because they have added fragrance quite high on the ingredients list. So yeah. And it is a shame because I was really interested in this. So there's that. I could potentially see myself trying one of the cleansers. That I could see myself do. Or yeah, that's basically the only thing that I would try from this line. So yeah, I'm just sticking to the ordinary for now, I think. Let's stay with Revolution Beauty because this is, let's see, new additions to their iconic and affordable Reloaded family, including going back to nearly 6 years ago when they launched and reloading to Iconic 1.0 and Iconic 2.0 to follow up our reloading of Iconic 3.0 last year. Hope you love them as much as they did creating them. I had three of their Iconic line. The first one that I got was the Neutrals. Which was pinky based. I gave that to my sister. It was a nice quality. wasn't anything to write home about, but it was not terrible. That was when I kind of started my makeup journey, so I did not really know my preference. But yeah, if you are a beginner, it's a very nice palette. I since then have added two of those reloaded ones to my collection that are still in my collection. The last one that I added was their gray one. The gray, black, and that one is actually very nice. So their formula is getting better and better. You know, and these are cheap as chips. Here you pay 5 or 6 euros. And they are definitely worth that price. So if you see them and you like the color story, just, you know, go check them out. I kind of like them. I don't hate the color story. You have one that is kind of a cooler tone, neutral. You have a bright. You have shimmer and let's see. In the brights palette, you have some more mattes than in the other palettes. Because when I zoom in and look at the neutral palettes, it seems to be that they have more shimmers than mattes in them. So yeah, I do have to say that if I am working with a colorful palette, I prefer more mattes than shimmers, or at least equal. If I'm working with a neutral palette, however, I can very easily just use one brown in my crease, and then, you know, play with the depth, shear it out, build it up, and then add different colored shimmers. So I am actually, that's something that I'm kind of finding out, you know, that if I work with a colorful palette, I want more mattes. If I work with a neutral palette, I'm okay if I have more shimmers than mattes. Am I alone in that? Let me know, because I'm kind of curious. So yeah. That's basically it. I think they're cute. I don't see myself necessarily getting one, but yeah, if you like the color story, definitely go check them out. That is all I can say. Okay, the next thing from Team Revolution Beauty is new eye wardrobe. And it is not just mascara. I have a picture here of mascara. Do I have a picture of anything else? Oh yeah, I have a picture here from the mascaras, then eye pencils and the brow thingy. They also have stamps. So let me read. What do they have? Yeah, mascara. Yes. Eyeliners. Fast brow pomade. 5 days ago. So I think a lot of this is online already. Oh yeah, that was that. What the hell do I do with that? That fast brow pomade thingy. I'm not really a pomade girl. I'm a pencil girl. Because for me that's easier. So yeah, I think that is basically it. The colors of the eye pencils look cute, but it's not something that I need right now. The mascaras, yeah, I don't know. If I see them in store, maybe I will try it. But for now, I'm actually very happy with my Glam & Doll line. So I don't know. If I were to get any, it would be probably waterproof. So yeah, let me know down below. Maybe you have tried one already. Let me know. Let me know if you are excited. I think it is cool that they are kind of expanding. And I think it is something that is, yeah, maybe they are very good at. I don't know. Okay, let's next go to Maybelline. Because they have launched their new Cheek Heat Gel Cream Blush. It provides a soft, buildable color for a glow that's all natural. The gel cream formula is lightweight and breathable for a silky application. The water-infused color pigments create a buildable soft color. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shades. And it is apparently available globally at Maybelline retailers now. I also see the swatches. They look pretty. I do, by the way, when I was at Action last, they had these from Rimmel. These are cream blushes that I haven't used yet. I got them out of the packaging, but I keep forgetting to use them. I kind of want to get a little bit more into the cream products. I have a cream bronzer stick that I like. But I find that sometimes, for instance, with my IT Cosmetics CC cream, I think I would prefer cream products on top of that instead of powdered products. But I want to play with that. So that is why I got these. They were under 2 euros each. So, you know. So I thought, let me try those. These actually look very interesting to me. To be quite honest with you, I don't know what they will retail for. I don't think I've seen them in store just yet. But then again, we have I'm going to film how minuscule our drugstore is. Because I think a lot of you will be very sad for me. But yeah, if I see these, it could very well be that I will pick one up on sale, though. I will probably not pay full price, but I'm very interested in these. So let me know if you have tried them and how they work for you. Okay, let's next go to ColourPop, because they have launched, I don't really know, their Luxe Velvet Duos for Valentine's Day. You get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different sets, and they contain 2 liquid lip thingy. There are very, very cute colors in here, by the way. Just saying. And I thought that I, or at least that was my understanding, that they also had a Luxe Velvet lipstick. And now they kind of have it in these sets. Did I see someone? I think I have someone in my watch later list that swatches them or uses them for the first time. I don't know. They do look interesting. I have had one of the blotted lips from ColourPop that I liked. I decluttered it because it was the wrong shade for me. I still kind of want to try their lippy sticks. So yeah, I am interested in these because I think, I don't know. Let me know how they are if you have tried them. Oh, they have launched already, yeah. And they retail for $15 per duo or $8 each. Ah, so you can get them separately as well. Okay, I wish we could get ColourPop easier here in Europe, by the way. This is from Trend Mood and it is a sneak peek, that's what it says here, for a new collection by ColourPop, which includes a UR... a QT eyeshadow palette, I Love You So Much, I think, Super Shock Cheek Duo, then an XO Lippy Trio, and then TLC BFF Mascara and Liner. I actually like the colors of the eyeshadow palette a lot. I like those rosy tones. So yeah, and because I'm Liora says, always says, because she is allowing herself to like neutrals, and I think that sums it up so nicely for me as well. I am also allowing myself to explore my love for neutrals and that. So I'm not hating the fact that there are neutrals in here. I actually think that it complements the palette. So yeah. I don't know when it goes online though. I thought I already saw it somewhere. But I don't know. I do like the color story. So yeah, there is that. Okay. Let's go next to Essence. Because they are... they have launched these already, I think. Yeah, they are vegan. The Perfect Matte Lipsticks in red tones, I think. Smooth like red velvet. Yeah, I think so. They retail for, €3. I have not seen these yet. I have been eyeing them. I have been eyeing the Essence displays. But again, where I live, it is very, very tiny. So when I am in Alkmaar next, I will look there. Because they have still a tiny drugstore, but a lot bigger of a display for Essence. I have some of their Shine lipsticks from this same range. They are okay. It's not a bad formula. It is just not my preferred lipstick kind, I believe. I don't really know how to explain it, but it is not really a gloss, it's not really a balm, but it is not really me. That's maybe a better thing. But these colors look very, very pretty. I do have from Catrice some velvet matte lipstick pens too. I have 2 of them. I kind of want to try this one, this formula as well, and I like the fact that it is a smaller bullet instead of the bigger bullet. So yeah, if I see them, I will try them. If you have, let me know. The next thing that I have from Essence here is a different falsies. They retail for €3 a pair. And this is from their Party of My Life Trend Edition. And some looked cute. The orange box looks very cute. If I see them and they don't look too plasticky, I will try a pair. I haven't seen this trend edition in store because we still have the Mystical Magical Me trend edition, which I believe is from last year. But yeah, we have it in store now. So there's that. I haven't picked anything up from that line. And I don't know if I will from this one. I will see when the trend edition hits. If it hits here, I don't know. Next, let's go to a sneak peek of 50-50 makeup. They are kind of playing a guessing game and they have a teaser and all that goodness. Because they are working on their spring palette. I have a picture of the outside, and I know that they have, as I'm filming this, released the first shade, which is called Caterpillar, which is a green, which is a kind of a shimmery, grassy green. Very, very cute. So yeah, and you get names like Tulip, which is, yeah, basically the Netherlands is famous for its tulips, which is kind of funny because tulips originated in Turkey. But yeah, that's neither here nor there. So they have, and yeah, I cannot wait to just see all the flower fields here, you know, and then smell them when the wind is just right. It's just, it's one of the best times here, I think. And where I live, we have a lot of bulb farmers, I think you should call them, or whatever. So we have a lot of fields with tulips and hyacinths here, and then never mind. But anyway, it drops the February the 5th on 12 p.m. CET on their website. I'm going to get me this. Just saying. I have an affiliate code with them as well, which is down in my description box. They are just an amazing brand. And if you follow me a little bit longer, they are one of my favorite brands. They are a Dutch-based indie brand with a fantastic philosophy. So definitely go check out their website and keep an eye on this palette. So yeah, I am very, very excited. Okay, the next is the reveal of the Midas Cosmetics and Smoky Glow collab. You see the picture here. I watched Hannah's reveal video and the palette is very, very her. I was debating pre-ordering it or not, because you basically had an open window. She said that in her video as well, for the 25th of January, where people who were watching her and who were subscribed to Midas Cosmetics would get the opportunity to get the palettes early, the goodies earlier, then it would go globally. I was debating it, and while I really like the color story and I think it is very much her, it is for me not interesting enough to wait for it. And maybe I need to clarify that a little bit, because I'm based here in the Netherlands. Midas Cosmetics is based in America. So even if I were to pre-order it, I am not one of the first to have a video up then. It's just because I have to wait for it a little while longer. That being said, that kind of makes me look twice at an eyeshadow palette. Do I really want it? So, or do I want it for my channel? If I want it for my channel because something is very hyped, I need to get my hands on it first. That's basically it. That's the way it works, you know? So then I'm like, it was like with the Blue Blood, I could get my hands on it very, very quickly here, because they had it in stock in the Netherlands. So I ordered it and the next day I delivered it, and I was one of the first who had it online. And that then gives my channel a boost, you know? Usually that is not the case. So usually I need to really want a palette, especially if it is from outside of Europe. And while I like this, I do, I really like it. I like the whole collection. It is not grabbing me enough to get it. No, I'm very happy for her, and I'm sure it will sell out and it will be a huge success. And yes, it does look pretty, and yes, there are some unique shades in here, and I would love to support her, but I'm choosing this time to support her with my view instead of buying her collection. That's my my decision on this collection now. There is a code available, however. You can use Amy Loves, you can use Hannah's code as well. First time you're on film while you are 18.
Oh fuck.
Yes. Did you have a good sporty thingy?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yes. Now it is focusing on you and not on me. It is not seeing my
face. I'm way more important than you.
It's not seeing my face as a face.
I'm the backbone of this channel.
So sad. Yeah, you kind of are, along with your cat.
Of course, he's my cat.
Yes, I know. So, I was giving you prices before we were so rudely interrupted because my battery ran out, and then, well, we had a visitor. So yeah, let's see. The official launch is the 20th. Public pre-orders will be available the 28th, and the official launch is on Valentine's Day. The palette retails for $36. Highlighter duo for $21, and the lip gloss trio for $25. But I know that you can also get it in a bundle. So yeah, that was it. Let me know down below if you have ordered it, if you are excited, if you're getting it or not. Let's chat about it in the comment section. Next, let's go to Smashbox, because they have released a collaboration with Birds of Prey. And it is Lippies. And I like the color. I like the brownie color a lot, actually, which is for... I have no freaking idea. It says here, with artwork inspired by Harley Quinn, Huntress and Black Canary from the movie Birds of Prey. Yeah, okay, so I have not seen the movie Birds of Prey. Maybe... Oh, is it nice?
Yeah, it's kind of good.
Okay. So apparently it's kind of good. So there's that. Okay, let's see here. These rich, long-wearing lipsticks glide on like a cream. And set to a velvety matte without drying out your lips. They're transfer resistant, waterproof and won't cake, fade, flake, bleed, smudge or feather for 12 hours. Always on cream to matte gives you the look of a liquid lipstick, yet easily applies like a traditional lipstick. The Black Canary one is called is the shade Stepping Out. Harley Quinn is the shade Balls. And Huntress is Hoops On. And I think that was the one that I liked from Huntress. Yeah. So, yeah. They retail for $24. They are available on Smashbox Cosmetics and Macy's. I don't know if it is the outer box that is decorated or also the lipstick tube thingy outer packaging itself. I don't know. Let me know if you are excited about this. Let's go to Pinky Rose next, because they are releasing two palettes. They are releasing the Sunflower and the Luscious Plum. And let's chat about them per palette. Let's start with the Sunflower one. While I like the color story, the big shade, the big pan is annoying me. I wish that they would have just made it two shades. Because I kind of don't get it. It is called transition. So yeah, you can use it as a transition shade. But maybe as a contour shade, if you have the correct color. Yes, you can use the shade beneath that as kind of a shimmery blush. But you can do that with your eyeshadow anyway. While it is a very pretty color story, the color that... it does not scream Sunflower to me. Because in my... eyes, the sunflowers, at least that we have here, have different yellows, have different greens, have other colors that are in here. So yeah, when I think of a sunflower, I think of the basic sunflower, the bright yellow petals, the black in the center, and then the green stem, and that is the colors that I'm missing here. I do like the color story, but for me it is because it is maybe a little bit more muted, more for fall. On the other hand, when we are going to spring, the other half of the world is going into fall. So yeah, then it would be a perfect palette, I think. For me, although I like the color story, it does not scream. Yeah, Sunflower and the big pen annoys me. Okay, they are available already and they retail for $22 each. So yeah. The next one is Luscious Plum. Same with that big ass transition shade, although I really like this transition shade. I wish that they would just put in an extra eyeshadow shade. You know, it's just... Let me know what you think down below. I'm missing something in the Plum palette, but I don't really know actually. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of it. Maybe you have already grabbed it, so yeah. Okay, next is Anastasia Beverly Hills, because here you see the Norvina Mini Volume 3. It launches today. I don't know what time, but it launches today on the 27th. And what do you think? I knew that they were coming out with a few other things because they announced it. So we kind of knew that one of these was coming. I actually like the fact that they are also bringing out smaller palettes. So I don't have to buy... For instance, a big-ass, huge Norvina palette, I can get a smaller one as well. I think it is, yeah, cherry. Yes, I don't really understand that kind of light pop of blue there. If we are going for cherries, I'm kind of missing then that really deep, dark cherry purple. But yeah, I don't mind the color story that much. Again, here, there is something missing in this palette. I just don't really know what. Yeah, that very, I don't know. Let me know down below what you think of it. I kind of like it and I kind of don't. So yeah, there's that. Okay, let's next go to Natasha Denona. And I have two things from her. So let's start with the face palette first, because otherwise I'm going to forget. So this is the Love Glow Cheek Palette. What was there? Did I not have more information? Oh yeah, here. Let's see. It is available the January the 28th at Natasha Denona, Sephora Europe Beautylish. I don't really understand what they mean with this, but I will read it anyway. It says available all doors Sephora US February 6th and Sephora Europe February 17th. It retails for $55. I think that means that they are then in store. But yeah, $55 for a face palette. Yeah, it looked pretty, but oh my lord, it's expensive. Let me know if it is worth it. I don't know. Let's go to the eyeshadow palette that she is coming out with as well. It's a limited edition Love eyeshadow palette. 15 new shades of pinks, mauves, purples, coral, silver and neutrals, rich burgundies and a fiery red. It is available 28th of January at Sephora Europe and Beautylish and NatashaDenona.com. So it's basically the same as the face palette. This retails for $65. I saw swatches and I like them, but when I look at the palette, I'm like, meh. It's meh. Also, I have here her mini, what's it called again? The mini Lila palette. Yeah, it's not that good. I'm sorry, it was a present from one of you and I'm very happy that I have it, but it is not that good. In my opinion, at least. I'm apparently used to something different, so yeah. I do really like the colors of that mini gold palette that she came out with, though. That is very, very pretty. But yeah, I have no idea if this is worth the money. Not for me. Let's just say that it is not worth it for me, but maybe it is for you. Yeah, it stuff does look pretty though. There's that. Okay, let's go to Hello Cosmetics. What? Hello, not as in hi, hello, but in hello as in hello. Like Halloween, like holy. That's it. That was the word I was looking for. They are coming out with blushes and highlighters. The blushes and highlighters are both live though. Okay. So I wanted to show these because they are very, very pretty. I love that pinky one. So I also have swatches. Let me save it. You will know that I have swatches because you will have seen them probably. I like the pinky one in the middle. I think that's very, very pretty. And it is kind of a pinky shimmery blush. I think it's very pretty. So yeah, that's it. The highlighters I have swatches for as well. They are called Blinding Bitch and Peaches and Cream. So from left to right you have Peaches and Cream and then Blinding Bitch. Yeah, very, very pretty. So yeah, but that pinky blush. I have not tried anything from Hello Cosmetics, but I did want to mention it anyway. And their information will be down in the description box. Okay, next is something I got tagged in, I believe, from J.Cat Beauty. And I know of J.Cat Beauty because of their, I think it's their pocket palettes that I know of. And these are their Noche palette and their Peak Time palette. So their Noche and Peak Time. Both are available at jcatbeauty.com for $8 each. So you have the Noche is basically a neutral with a pop of blue. The top row seems to be mattes and then the bottom two rows seem to be shimmers. And then you have the Peak Time, which is brights. And looks to be a combination of shimmers and mattes. I have never tried anything from J.Cat Beauty. The price is very, very nice. The brights palettes, I have all those colors. And the neutrals palette. Yeah, it's pretty and I could do some pretty looks with it, but I don't know, it does not really grab my attention that much today, to be quite honest with you. I am actually very curious about their quality though. So if you have tried J.Cat Beauty, let me know. If you have tried these palettes, obviously let me know, because I'm very, very curious to hear how the formula is. So, yeah. Okay, let's next go to Estee Lauder, because they have released a new foundation. It's the Futurist Hydra Rescue Moisturizing Makeup with SPF 45, described as flawless makeup with serious skincare. Coverage and care. It's powered with high-performance Estee Lauder skincare. Okay. Breathable, skin-loving makeup with a 12-hour radiant glow. This moisturizing makeup is infused with their iron-charged water, plus probiotic technology and chia seed extract. Clinical testing shows it soothes, protects, and hydrates. Buildable medium to full coverage, lightweight formula, evens out skin tone, covers redness, dark spots, and imperfections, rescues skin, blah, blah, blah. Broad spectrum UVA, UVB. It retails for $45 in 20 shades. Okay. I have opinions. While it sounds nice, and what sounds nice for me, it's basically the fact that it is light and has a high coverage and is buildable. That is what I like about it. The SPF that is in there is fine to kind of make sure that I have an even sunscreen layer on my skin. However, I always, and I mean always, wear a sunscreen, a separate sunscreen underneath my makeup. So between my skincare and my makeup is a layer of sunscreen. I do that because I spend a lot of money on my skin and I want to have it looking as nice for as long as possible. That means separate sunscreen. The sunscreen in your makeup is not enough, because to have the coverage listed on the tube or bottle or whatever, you need a quarter teaspoon for your face and neck. That is so freaking much. So I kind of layer, you know? So that is the reason I don't mind it per se in my foundation, but I don't rely on it, because I rely on the sunscreen layer underneath. That said, because I have a sunscreen layer between that, you know, I don't know how beneficial it is for me to have skincare in my foundation, because I don't know how well it kind of penetrates my SPF, you know. So for me, all that nice, I don't know, good skincare stuff that is in my foundation, it doesn't really do a lot. You know? I think, at least. So yeah, that is me personally. Also, the same with eyeshadow. You know? Skincare in your eyeshadow, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Mineral, I don't know, people. But yeah. Yeah, it does sound interesting, but if you love your skin, please use a separate sunscreen. Oh no, it is back.
Back in black.
Yes, where's your new slothy friend?
It's downstairs.
Oh, it's so cute.
Shall I show you the sloth? Shall I show them the sloth?
Yeah, show them the sloth. Okay.
I'll be right back.
Yes. So yeah, that was Estee Lauder. Let me know what you think of it. Let's go next to Etude House Official, because they are launching a collaboration with Hershey's for Valentine's Day. Etude House does the most fun stuff, you know? Is it gimmicky? Sure. Is it childish? Yeah. Maybe. But I like it anyway. So basically, this is chocolate. I like them. I actually like the color story in both palettes. I like them. Oh yes, meet our newest addition to the family. It is a sloth. Let me go to this side. Very, very cute. Okay. Thank you. So we have a mascot now. Say. Let's go back to Etude House. Anyway, I kind of like it. You have an eyeshadow palette. You also get a creamy milk chocolate powder rouge tint. What is that? Lipsticks, I think. And brushes? Yes. So it is not a very big collection, but I do... Oh, I could also read. Never mind. So you get a Hershey Play Color Eyes Mini in the color Original and then Cookies and Cream. Then you get a Hershey Powder Rouge tint. So a blush, I think. In hazelnut chocolate and almond chocolate, I think. Rouge for us is blush. I don't. And then you get the Hershey eyeshadow brush. The original and cookies and cream. Oh, wait. So that powder rouge tint is probably lipstick, I think. But yeah, I like it. I like the collection. I think it's fun. Yeah, they're neutral shades. You get a milk chocolate and you get another chocolate bar palette. I like it. I think it's fun. So yeah, it is available already on Etude House Official. And the 1st of February on Etude House Japan. I don't know if this will come to Yes Style. So there is that. But I did want to mention it because I thought it was fun. Am I still recording? Yes. Okay. It's going to be an editing nightmare this. And this needs to go up tomorrow. So yay me. Is this the last thing? Yeah, this is the last thing from Nude Sticks. This is the Magnetic Lip Plush Paints collection. It is, where luxury K-beauty and all-over color meets multitasking longwear performance. Get a feather light, velvety matte finish in a wide range of soft nude lip colors. Each of these gorgeous plush paints are customizable as a lip stain, a lipstick or a lip pencil for all over on-the-go convenience. I don't get it. Wait, do not do that. So what? It just means that you can build it up, basically, I think. Because, yeah, if I have a doe foot, I can kind of use the doe foot as a lip liner. So, yeah, but we can do that with... Oh, you can also use it as an eyeshadow. What is it then? Okay, so it's for your lips, but you can also apparently use it on your eyes. Okay, so you can use lipstick as a blush as well, but it's multi-talented. Okay, they are completely cruelty-free, so that is very good. Formulated with 8 natural extract, yeah. I don't get the magnetic part though. It's available in 7 shades. Retails for $28. But what is the magnetic part then? I don't know. But that was it for me for this week. That was everything that I wanted to talk about. And probably there will be more that I have kind of missed. Because I am pre-filming this video. So yeah. There's that. Let me know what you thought of the finds that I had this week. And if there is something that you want me to talk about, you know, that you see floating around on Instagram, tag me in it. Or better yet, send it through DM so I am sure that I will see it. Because I will probably miss it if you tag me in it. If you are not following me on Instagram already, my handle is down in the description box. It will probably be flashing on the screen as well. And it is on my end screen. So there are multiple ways of finding me on Instagram. This was it. If you are new here, thank you so much for watching. I hope you will consider subscribing. Do check out the rest of my channel because this is an episode that I do, or actually a series that I do on my channel every single Monday. But I do lots more. I do makeup tutorials. I do multiple looks with palettes. I do colorful makeup. I am discovering my love for neutral makeup. And I kind of want to do some makeup hacks this year. I did one, which was kind of faking lip fillers, you know. And I thought it might be fun if I do some other makeup hack type videos. Because I had a lot of fun filming that. So if there is a makeup hack that you want me to try, let me know down below. I am curious. Yes. Wow. I'm going to sign off. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys. I think I forgot to take... Oh.